Good evening and welcome to MTV's News Update May 21, 2020 edition. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, the top stories we are tracking this evening. 87 ballot boxes completed today, highest since the recount started. Carter Center disappointed over denial of observers to Guyana. GCOM cannot verify death certificates presented by Coalition, PRO says. COVID-19 cases in Guyana climbed to 127, deaths remain at 10. And in sport, West Indies tour of England becoming more likely following positive discussions. Now for the news in details. GCOM today recounted the highest number of ballot boxes, a record 87. The remaining ballot boxes stand at 1,468.
The process completed the highest number of boxes, 87 boxes. Taking the total of completed boxes to 878 and leaving 1,461 boxes remaining. So we are very pleased that the pace has increased significantly with the addition of the two stations. You see, we have moved from an average of about 51, 52 to now as high as 87.
PPP Anil Nandlal went on to admonish GCOM for relying on the COVID-19 task force for the establishment of more counting stations. He said the task force's approval is not necessary. Meanwhile, Nandlal said the figures from the recount are confirming the statements of polls in the possession of his party.
Mingo's fraud allocated fraudulently and wrongly 4,415 votes to APNU AFC from 85 boxes only, and reduced PPP votes by 686.
Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
More coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
Are you washing your hands correctly? Here are some tips on when and how to wash your hands. Step 1. Wet your hands with clean water. Step 2. Then apply soap. Step 3. For 10 to 15 seconds, lather your palms together. Always remember to pay attention to your fingers, especially your nails and tips. And don't forget the back and between of your fingers. Step 4. Rinse hands with clean water for about 20 seconds. Step 5. Dry hands with a clean paper towel or tissue.
But when should you wash your hands? After using the toilet, before and after eating, preparing or handling uncooked food, after playing with pets or caring for animals, after sneezing and coughing or blowing your nose, before and after changing babies or caring for others.
Frequent hand washing or using a hand sanitizer with alcohol as an alternative will remove viruses and bacteria from your hands.
A message from the Ministry of Public Health in collaboration with PAHO WHO.
Welcome back. The Carter Center today expressed disappointment over the refusal of the government of Guyana to allow its observers to complete their work by observing the ongoing recount. The observers have been denied entry into Guyana.
The Carter Center today expressed the dissatisfaction that its observers have not been allowed to return to Guyana. The government had previously denied the entry of the observers, claiming due to the COVID-19 pandemic and the closure of airports, it would not be possible for them to return to Guyana. This is despite flights were granted permission to come to Guyana to return Guyanese. The government had also expressed immense confidence in CARICOM to observe the national recount of votes cast on March 2. Today, the Carter Center said the government of Guyana chose not to demonstrate a genuine commitment to transparency by ensuring all duly accredited organizations, including the Carter Center, be allowed to conduct their work. The Carter Center wanted two observers to return. However, the observer mission reiterated that the tabulation process lacked transparency in Region 4, making the process not credible. The mission said a flawed vote count or vote tabulation can fatally undermine the integrity and the credibility of the electoral process and decrease public acceptance of the results. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Chairman of the Guyana Elections Commission, retired Justice Claudette Singh, today said anyone making objection must prove their case. The APNU AFC has been making numerous objections and has brought death certificates to the commission.
The statement by retired Justice Claudette Singh came a day after Commissioner Sais Gonraj claimed that the chairperson said she did not believe it was GCOM's role to probe claims of irregularities. The coalition has been making objections to persons claiming they were not present in Guyana on March 2 or have deceased. Justice Singh, in that letter, made it known that the commission has not yet fully discussed the matter. She said any decision of GCOM will be communicated to political parties and other stakeholders. Meanwhile, members of the coalition have been calling for fresh elections in certain regions, claiming the anomalies during the tabulation are numerous. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Public Relations Officer of the Guyana Elections Commission, Yolanda Ward, told media operatives that the commission cannot verify the death certificates brought forward by the coalition. The coalition presented a certificate as proof that electoral fraud occurred. The coalition has been objecting to a number of names of persons that voted on March 2, claiming that those persons either died or were abroad on Elections Day. The opposition People's Progressive Party has repeatedly said the objections by the coalition is meant to delay and frustrate the recount with the aim of invalidating the elections. A number of persons have been coming forward presenting proof of presence in Guyana on March 2, attempting to validate their vote. The Private Sector Commission wants assurance from President David Granger that the results from the National Votes Recount would be accepted by that Partnership for National Unity, Alliance for Change. This follows the refusal by an APNU AFC agent to sign a certification of tabulation to validate the recount for Region 2.
The Private Sector Commission said Guyanese would be at ease if the President gives assurance to accept the findings of the recount and for it to be used to declare a winner. President David Granger has committed that he will abide by the final declaration from the Guyana Elections Commission. The PSC said it would have also been more assuring had the president rejected the initial declaration of the March 2 elections, which included the fraudulent results for District 4. However, the private sector is pleased that the president has restored public confidence in the national recount, deeming it necessary to determine the credible and final results of the March 2 elections. Coalition members have come forward saying the entire elections can be invalidated if the name of a dead person had been used to cast the vote on March 2, 2020. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
Still ahead, government creating database to provide relief to most vulnerable and small businesses to benefit from grant from Small Business Bureau.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. Our wall and ceiling gypsum system. It's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Cherry Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
Are you having sore throat, fever, coughing, headache, or runny nose? Take Cetamol Cold and Flu day or night. Ask your pharmacist for Cetamol Cold and Flu and get back to the happier you.
Distributed by Massey Distribution.
Are you having sore throat, fever, coughing, headache, or runny nose? Take Cetamol Cold and Flu day or night. Ask your pharmacist for Cetamol Cold and Flu and get back to the happier you.
Distributed by Massey Distribution.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
As two more men tested positive today for COVID-19, the Ministry of Public Health is pleading with the Guyanese, more so the male population, to adhere to the safety guidelines.
According to the ministry's statistics, the male-to-female ratio of COVID-19 cases stands at 73 to 54 of 127 cases. 57% of persons affected by the disease are males. To date, 1,329 persons have been tested, with 1,202 of those tests returning negative. 57 persons have since recovered from the disease. 60 persons remain in isolation, and 3 persons are currently in the ICU. The death toll remains at 10. The ministry in the briefing informed that there are now 2 cases confirmed in Region 1 and 7 cases in Region 7. The Ministry of Public Health reminded that in order to defeat the deadly disease, everyone needs to follow the safety guidelines in order to protect themselves and others. The total number of cases globally is now at 4,789,205, with 318,789 deaths. In the region of the Americas, there are 2,105,670 cases, with 125,843 deaths. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
The government has launched a data collection mechanism aimed at identifying and providing tangible support for vulnerable households affected by the COVID-19 pandemic and its emergency measures. This will be used to allocate relief after verification.
The initiative is made possible through a collaborative effort of the National COVID-19 Task Force Executive Secretariat, the Civil Defense Commission, Ministry of Social Protection, Ministry of Communities, and the Ministry of Indigenous Peoples Affairs. Persons in dire need of assistance or most vulnerable during this period are encouraged to apply. Assistance will be given on a needs basis to ensure the most affected persons are reached and supported. Applications can be done both manually and online. Online submissions will commence today, while manual submissions are scheduled to begin by May 27. Application forms can be downloaded from the Ministry of Social Protection's website. To qualify, applicants must be currently benefiting from public assistance provided by the Ministry of Social Protection or have applied for assistance. Individuals or households headed by senior citizens or persons with disabilities or who may have suffered a loss of income due to COVID-19 will also be considered. The Ministry of Social Protection will release additional information, including telephone numbers for citizens who qualify to call at a later date. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
The Small Business Bureau is set to distribute grants to owners of small businesses affected by the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic.
The grant is specific to businesses registered under the Small Business Bureau. Applications can be completed online and is being conducted on a first-come, first-served basis. Chief Executive Officer Dr. Lowell Porter explained once the applicants meet all the necessary criteria, the agency will disperse that grant in 5 days. While noting that the Small Business Bureau will not limit the scope of applicants, Dr. Porter said priority will be given to essential businesses that have been affected by COVID-19. These include establishments involved in food production and healthcare items. He also made it clear that the relief is a grant and not a loan. As such, businesses will not have to repay. Interested persons who are unable to complete the form online also have the option to book an appointment with the Small Business Bureau. Application forms can be found on their website www.sbb.gov.gy. Luan Williams for MTV's News Update.
More news still ahead. Stay tuned.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1 year factory warranty, along with our after-sales service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Using Softex toilet tissue. Available in leading supermarkets countrywide, Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Start feeling good again with Probiotic XL. Probiotic XL contains a proprietary formula of 10 of the most important probiotics that have been researched and developed to help your body get rid of what's bad for it and help promote what makes you feel good. If leading a healthy life and enjoying every day is something you want to do, then Probiotic XL is for you.
Planning your next business trip or vacation to the U.S., Europe, Africa, Asia, or the Caribbean is made easier with the help of Survival Travel Agency. Our experienced and friendly travel agent.
Gaffords, manufacturers of the perfect concrete hollow block in sizes 4 inches and 6 inches. Certified by the Ghana National Bureau of Standards, and hydraulically tested by the University of Guyana to 2,000 pounds per square inch. Pallet packed and shrink wrapped for easy transportation too. So get your supplies of the best quality made concrete hollow blocks in Guyana and also get a 12.5% discount. For superior service, quality and competitive prices, visit Gafu's Mega Complex at Makdu and our outlets at Rose Hall, Kanji, Bedford Acting, Memes, Land of Canaan and Parika.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
Now for your sport news. The Board of Control for Cricket in India is optimistic about the Indian Premier League taking place after clearance from the federal government.
The IPL was postponed indefinitely in April due to the COVID-19 pandemic, which put the world in a lockdown. This week, the Indian government said sporting facilities and stadiums could reopen, but behind closed doors. However, the Indian Ministry of Health said sports gatherings would not be allowed, leaving a question mark over when sport would be safe to return. The BCCI will allow Indian players to decide for themselves whether or not to return to play when cricket resumes. Chief Executive Rahul Jory assured player safety would be given paramount importance. The board will continue to wait for restrictions to ease before asking players at all levels to return to training. Chelsea Lee, reporter for MTV's Sports Update.
Super League clubs have drawn up plans for the possible return of top-flight action by mid-August, and the 12 sides are hoping that matches can be played in front of limited crowds from October 1. The plans, seen by BBC Sport, will be put to the Rugby Football League Board of Directors next week. Three models for fixtures have been put forward, which would see the season end in a grand final on either November 28 to December 12 or mid-January 2021. International Olympic Committee President Thomas Bach understands why the rescheduled Tokyo Olympic Games would have to be cancelled and accepts if it is not held.
Bach told BBC Sport athletes cannot be left in uncertainty. He admitted reorganizing the Games was a mammoth task and warned the event would definitely be different with a focus on essentials. Local organizers said there are no backup plans after the event was postponed by a year due to the coronavirus crisis. Bach insisted staging the Games behind closed doors was not what they want, but he needs more time to consider the feasibility. He hoped the first ever postponed Games due next summer could prove unique, sending a message of triumph over the coronavirus. As there is no blueprint, they have to reinvent the wheel day by day. It is challenging but fascinating. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
The West Indies tour of England this summer is becoming likely following discussions between the England and Wales Cricket Board and Cricket West Indies.
The medical team and staff of both boards have been in discussion since the start of the month to pave the way for the West Indies to travel to England. The two sides are due for a three-test series in July, which was originally slated for June. The tour was postponed due to the coronavirus pandemic and player safety. However, last week, CWI notified a training squad of 30 they should prepare to travel and play in England if the tour can go ahead. CWI's CEO Johnny Graves said talks revealed the ECB is confident they can deliver a safe plan for biosecure behind closed doors cricket. The CWI medical and support staff have determined that the Windies would need at least 4 weeks to get the players into the condition that they need to be in to face England in the test matches. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
England's women could host a tri-series featuring India and South Africa later this summer, according to director of cricket Clare Connor. India's tour, scheduled for June and July, was postponed due to the coronavirus pandemic, while South Africa is slated to travel in September. Connor said they are optimistic of holding at least one series. She added it could be that they play two series concurrently and look at a tri-series. Everything is possible. England's men began training this week and the women are planning to return on about June 22. A revamped men's schedule involving games behind closed doors is due to be released by the end of May, with Connor explaining that women's fixtures have been involved in the discussions around holding fixtures in a biosecure environment. And that brings us to the end of Sport Update. More after the break.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sale service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
This is where we wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. 87 ballot boxes completed today, highest since the recount started. Carter Center disappointed over denial of observers to Guyana. GCOM cannot verify death certificates presented by Coalition, PRO says. COVID-19 cases in Guyana climbed to 127, deaths remain at 10. And in sport, West Indies tour of England becoming more likely following positive discussions. Kachori broadcasts at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Ashley Scotland. Good night.